Did you know that tech employees can make up to 85% more than employees in other industries? I know, when I first heard this stat, I was pretty much mind blown. Now, let's back up a sec. The stat also is dependent on different locations. So if you are in, you know, middle of America versus if you are in San Francisco, this stat will vary and it will change. But I still think it's very interesting to think about. In this video, we are going to be speaking about some of the top highest paying tech jobs for 2023. And I thought this was a very interesting video to film and research about because tech right now, no surprise to many of us, is in a very strange place. Let's say strange place, meaning there's a lot of hiring freezes going on. There's a lot of layoffs going on. So why would you even consider pursuing a career in tech? A lot of people are asking. And then there's others who are already in tech wondering, is my job, is my role valuable enough to the company that they will keep me? And this got me thinking, what is the research saying? What are the stats saying regarding what are the highest demand jobs or roles in tech? And does this align to, for me personally, where I am at? And I'm sure if you're watching this video, you are curious as to does it align with where you're at? Now I want to note, I'm going to go through the top in-demand, highest paying jobs in tech for 2023, but there are still some that I'm not going to list that of course are still high in demand. This video can only be so long, but I just wanted to note that. Okay, I'm sure on this list there is no surprise here, this made on the list, which is data scientist. In simple terms, what exactly does a data scientist do? A data scientist's job is to analyze data for actionable insights. So specific tasks can include identifying data analytics problems that offer the greatest opportunities to the organization. Now, the next question you might be asking is, well, what are some skills and requirements to become a data scientist? First off, I want to say for a lot of these roles, you don't need to go back to school to get a degree, to get a master's, but rather a lot of them can be through self-study, through going to different programs. So I really wanted to highlight that because I think it's one of the coolest things about tech and what it has to offer is there are so many ways to get into the industry. So some skills and requirements for a data scientist often include the knowledge of R, Python, or other database programming languages. You need to have experience or an understanding at least in statistical analysis and pattern recognition. So what are some primary duties? Well, actually, I was speaking to a data scientist in my Talk Tech with Tiff series, and one thing that I really love she highlighted is that it's not just, she said it really well. She's like, I don't just sit there and look at data or analyze data or code all day, but I actually have to talk to the stakeholders. I have to present this data to them as well. So it's a job that I think a lot of people would find surprising to say it's not just you speaking to the computer, but you also are speaking to stakeholders as well, which I really like. So it's kind of the best of both worlds. You still get to work on your soft skills and improve those while also working on your technical skills. Some primary duties include analyzing, sorting, and sanitizing data to yield actionable or meaningful results. Also, find better ways of collecting data to get meaningful information and create reports that are human friendly and readable. Kind of going back to presenting this to the stakeholders. Now, let's get to the most important part. How much does a data scientist make? Now, I just want to give a little side note here. These numbers, this total compensation that I'm doing is just that. It's total compensation, so it's base, it's equity, it's stock, etc. And I'm referencing them from Levels FYI. I'll link it down below. They have a ton of different roles. I'm on there right now and based from a ton of different locations, levels of your career, etc. So for data scientists, the medium, this means if you're taking into account the juniors as well, the very high seniors as well, but on average it's around 125,000. So you can see how, as this is the medium, as you grow in your career it will go quite higher than this, and also too, as you're starting on your career, you can still expect a great salary to begin with. Next on the list is cloud architect, and once again I'm sure this is not surprising to many of you. A cloud architect puts an organization's cloud computing strategy into action. So they come up with the strategy and then also to implement it. Okay, I'm on vacation, as you know, and it's getting a little noisy outside. Let's go back inside. Okay, this is what happens when you go on vacation and decide to continue to work. You gotta get creative, especially when it comes to filming. But anyways, next on the list, as I was mentioning, is cloud architect. A cloud architect designs, optimizes, and analyzes cloud networks. The stats for cloud and the jobs that are in demand for cloud is skyrocketing. Let me actually check it out because I'm not sure the exact stats. Cloud 2022, just the industry itself, because I was thinking of specializing in the cloud at one point, and I kind of still am. I think it's really interesting. Cloud services is forecast to grow 20% in 2022. Yeah, the stats around it is just crazy. Like, it's continuing to grow and grow. So although I'm speaking about cloud architect, I think any job within the cloud is such a great way to go. It's so interesting. And I always say that, I always think to myself that it would be either cloud for me or Web3. And maybe, you know, those two intertwined, but I think it's interesting just to see those two industries really growing. Okay, back to cloud architect, as we were saying. Some skills and requirements for a cloud architect include extensive knowledge of cloud infrastructure and cloud architecture. You also have to be competent in programming, knowing Python, JavaScript, and you also have to have knowledge in cloud infrastructures, platforms, and applications. Also, for this role, in the architect role, you have to have soft skills in communication, people skills, leadership skills, because you will be working with clients as well. So some duties, and this can vary based on company, include evaluating an organization's cloud network, monitoring cloud security and privacy, and proactively reacting to potential threats, and creating and maintaining a comprehensive cloud strategy. Now, when I said you might be working with clients, because sometimes, especially in a consulting world, you will be consulting other businesses on their cloud strategy or their how their architecture looks. So it can go both ways as well. Okay, let's get to the good part, the money part. For this one, it's not on Levels FYI, so I actually just typed it in and found from salary.com. So it's a range in the US from $143,000 to $165,000. So I think that number definitely can go up, especially when you start talking about total compensation as well, because I believe this is just salary, just base salary. Yeah, I believe this is base salary. But yeah, so it does definitely go up when you start talking about equity and stocks as well. Next on the list is blockchain engineer. And I'm sure you've seen news articles on this or read articles or blog posts online on just how well paid these blockchain engineers are and how in demand they are. Now, my next thing I get asked a lot is, well, Tiff, they're so high in demand, how do I become one? And I had this question too, as a developer, as an engineer, how do you get into the blockchain world? And the good news is if you're already a developer or software engineer, the path to becoming a blockchain engineer is much more, there's less hurdles you will have to overcome versus if you are just starting out. And that is because you already know programming. You think like a programmer, you are a programmer. So in order to learn to become a blockchain developer, you really just need to level up your skills, focus in on that area, which I think is really exciting because it's not something that you have to go back to school for another 4 years or anything like that. And even if you aren't a developer already, but you want to become one, it definitely is a great path that you can focus on as well. Also, as a side note, if you are looking to learn more about Web3 and building Web3, this isn't a sponsor or anything, but I am a huge fan of buildspace.so. And it just has, I'll put it up on screen here, because it has some amazing resources to build different products, and also too, it has a huge community. So that is just a little side tip from me. Do you? Okay, let's talk about salary for blockchain engineers. This one is a tough one because it still is pretty new that I find there is so much, when I was researching this, there's so much research out there that varies. So when I was speaking to some friends who are in the industry who focus on blockchain engineering, they kind of helped me come up with an accurate or more so accurate range. So what I did was when I was searching blockchain engineer initially, I came across this article on hired.com, and the salaries of candidates typically range from on the low side, $150,000 to on the high side, $200,000. So the medium would be around $180,000. And from what I have spoken to in the industry, this is pretty accurate. So that's a really high paying job if you ask me. And you get to build really cool tech. Next on the list is DevOps engineer. DevOps engineer is something, a role that I feel like is often hidden or within the company isn't spoke about as much as it should be. This is like the star of the show in the back end and running so many things, making sure everything's functioning okay, yet it doesn't get the recognition, in my opinion, that it really deserves. So if you are a DevOps engineer, you are the star of the show, in my opinion. Okay, but what exactly is a DevOps engineer for those of you who might not be as familiar with it? Essentially, a DevOps engineer is kind of what I just summed it up to be. They are responsible to ensure smooth operation for the company's IT infrastructure. So they work with developers to deploy and manage code changes, operations staff to ensure systems are up and running smoothly. They work with a few different departments, but at the end of the day, their priority is to make everything as smooth, as peaceful. And to be successful in a DevOps career, you not only need to have a strong understanding of development, but also to operational processes. Some of the skills for a DevOps engineer, they need coding, they also need to be able to write scripts and knowing how to set up and run a network, Git and Jenkins. Now, the average yearly salary, we have this on Levels FYI, let's look it up for DevOps. Okay, so DevOps can make a lot of money. I have one here after 8 years in the industry at Instacart, apparently. This is according to Levels FYI, that the total comp is $250,000 US, which that's a lot of money if you ask me. Okay, so more accurately though, actually that is accurate, but what I mean is the median would be closer to, let's see here. For a median salary, not total compensation for DevOps, it's around $140,000 US per year. Last but definitely not least on the list is cybersecurity. And this I'm going to speak about a cybersecurity engineer, but I really want to highlight cybersecurity as a whole. It needs so much more people in the industry. So even if you are not an engineer, this in part, this niche in the industry of cybersecurity is so in demand. It's continuing to grow. It's not going to slow down. And you don't need to be an engineer to work in cybersecurity. They need product managers. They need everything that everyone else does in the tech industry, they need, but you just need to have a strong understanding of what cybersecurity is. And the good thing is that's all available online, that you can take courses, you can read up on it, but it's a very growing industry. Now let's get back to cybersecurity engineer. Cybersecurity engineers are in charge of security functions that can include designing, developing, and implementing high securely network solutions. This also sometimes can include good hacking, which essentially is you are hacking into your own company's applications to see where the vulnerabilities lie. It's a very interesting career, and I had a good friend of mine who is a cybersecurity engineer, and getting to hear her stories not only about the apps she was testing at work too, but external ones and what's kind of going on behind the scenes. It was really exciting, but it also is very terrifying just how vulnerable I think a lot of applications are. Some other responsibilities for cybersecurity engineers can include penetration testing. So this means evaluating an organization's computer networks, applications, and data systems for vulnerabilities. So pretty much what I just said. Also to network maintenance. So you might need to install, test, and configure some networks. And IT system security. So spending time defining protocols and installing and configuring security devices. Okay, that's a lot. So you can see it's a very diverse job in the sense that you get to work on a lot of very interesting problems. Now, with such an important job, what is the salary for this? Okay, for this I went on ZipRecruiter and I can see here they say for salary, not total compensation. And I always really highlight those differences because it's easy to get the two mixed up when you were speaking to people or speaking to friends or whomever you're speaking to. And I want to really highlight this because a lot of times if someone says, oh, I make $250,000 a year, you need to clarify, okay, that's great, but is that total comp or is that base salary? Because that's a big difference. So that's why I always try and do that in these videos, is ensure I am clarifying what I'm speaking to. So this is for base salary, and the average, national average, is around $120,000 US. So this definitely can go up extremely as you grow in your cybersecurity career, but also too, you are starting with a very, not $120,000 typically, but you are starting with a very good salary as well. Okay, those are some of the top in-demand jobs or fields in the tech industry that are going to continue to really grow in 2023. And I'm really excited to see where they go because a lot of these industries or fields, I guess you could say, within the tech industry are just at the tip, just starting out. When you think about cybersecurity, when you think about blockchain, these fields, yes, they've been around for a while, but they have so much potential and they're going to unlock so many other things that being a part of that is really exciting. I'm curious to know, what specific field in tech are you working in? Or are you passionate about or want to get in? Leave down in the comments. Okay, the sun is calling me. I can see it from behind you. I need to go relax on a chair now. Thank you all for watching. Make sure to hit that subscribe button for more tech, coding, and career-related content. And I'll see you all soon. Bye, everyone.